retired racehorse project. Okay. And you're okay if we do a video interview?
Sure.
Perfect. Thank you. We just had clearly a very, very lovely test, so congratulations. But one thing that we, you know, have been following you have noticed is that your horse is clearly much more relaxed than he has been in years past. And I didn't know if you could talk a little bit about what you've worked on or what you've changed in your preparation at all.
I think we've both kind of matured a little bit. I don't know. I would say in general, we prioritize his relaxation as kind of the foundation of everything we're doing in his training. And I think we've been pretty consistent about that for the last couple years. And I think our whole program has sort of embraced that approach. And certainly with a horse like him, with his racing background and just his high kind of blooded nature, it's sort of necessary for us to kind of give him that extra time when he needs it and be a little bit conciliatory on
certain things.
Very
clearly working.
So yeah, I think we've been on a good trajectory the last couple of years, and we're just trying to get a little better every day. You want to go see mommy?
She's like, yes.
Go. So yeah, I think that's it for tight lines. I mean, he's like riding a bird on a wire, you know. He's a great horse, and he always gives me a real good effort.
Awesome.
Okay, my question is really serious, but I really just wanted to know what you listen to when you're warming up, because I noticed you had your AirPods in, and if you don't want to tell me, it's okay.
No,
I'm just curious.
Nothing.
Really?
Yes. I just put it in a little bit, so I check in with my wife, Katie, uh-huh. during the warm-up a little bit, uh-huh. so she doesn't have to yell.
Mm,
she's Canadian,
okay.
She's not a yeller.
Sure.
And I don't listen to music a lot when I ride, but I listen to music a lot when I'm not.
Cool. Yeah, I wasn't sure.
It's a good question. I love any questions related to music. I fully endorse.
Leslie's already working on your My Metal Jacket article.
That'd be pretty
no
sweet.
No pressure.
How did the horse look? Have you watched it?
I have, yeah. I've looked at it a couple times, and I think it's a tricky track, actually. I think there's some very clever lines and just so many places where he could kind of catch you out. I think it's a lot slower than in years past. I don't think the time is going to be anywhere near as gettable. And then with the weather, it might be even more so like that. But it's a great course. There's a lot to do, and it kind of builds the whole way around.
And you have 3 and 5-star. How are the rides going to be different?
I don't know if you could have 3 different horses, 4 different horses. Tight Lines is like a rocket ship, and Don Dante's 18-something hands, and then Off the Record's kind of somewhere in between the two. He's sort of like a bit of a maniac in his own right, so they'll be all very different, but I've had them all since they were really young. I know them well, and I'll try to make a plan for each one individually and hope it works.
Cool.
Overtown at 20.